Hello friends, today I am going to talk about the cost of capital. Cost of capital is very important subject in the financial management. It is a concept which is very much helpful to the finance managers. Here in financial decision paper, cost of capital is in the unit number 2. It is the one of the components of the unit number 2. So let us see what is the cost of capital, how the cost of capital is useful to finance managers. Cost of capital is important for two reasons. Number one, for financing decision and capital structure decision. Financing decision revolves around the cost of capitals. Because when we finance the project or we design the capital structure, we must consider the cost of each components of the capital structure. Second thing is a capital budgeting decision. Capital budgeting decisions is also based on cost of capital. We compare the cost of capital with the return on investment or expected rate of return. If the expected rate of return is more than the cost of capital, then we will take the decision, we accept the decision. So therefore we can say that for designing capital structure and for the capital budgeting decision, the cost of capital is very important. Apart from this, there are two views, there are two types of thoughts. One school of thoughts believe that the cost of capital is irrelevant to the value of the firm and to the capital structure. It means that we can design capital structure without considering the cost of capital. Particularly, Mori, Glani, Millers propounded a theory and they believe that the cost of capital is not relevant to the value of the firm and to the designing of capital structure. Particularly, optimum capital structure. When we design optimum capital structure, we need to consider cost of capital. But Mori, Glani, Miller has said that it is not important while designing the capital structure decision. Second thing, that the another school of thoughts believe that the cost of capital is very important because the value of the firm is affected by the cost of capital. Lower the cost of capital, higher is the value of the firm. So it means that both are correlated. Second thing, that the value of the you can say that optimum capital structure is also based on the cost of capital. So unless you have a minimum cost of capital, you cannot design the optimum capital structure. So here we can say that in the introduction that the cost of capital is very important for financing decision, for capital budgeting decisions, and even the value of the firm is also affected by the cost of capital. So cost of capital is very, very important for finance manager. Now let us see the definition of the cost of capital. There are three views about the cost of capital. Investors' perspective, firms itself views, and for capital budgeting or for capital expenditure, what we understand about the cost of capital. Investor's viewpoint, the measurement of the sacrifice made by him or her in order to capital formation. So here investors are putting their money in the business. They are sacrificing the investment or the money in the business. So they expect return against the sacrifice that is made by him or her. So obviously the amount of dividend that the investors are getting from the firm is, you can say, that return against the sacrifice. Particularly debenture holders, they give fund to the firm, right? And against this fund, firm is giving interest. So the interest is the amount that is received by the debenture holders against the sacrifice that they have made. So you can say that the sacrifice, it is the return against the sacrifice made by the investors. Now we look at the firm's point of view. It is a minimum rate of return required to earn by the firm from the project. So here it is a minimum rate of return that firm must earn from the project or from its investment. If minimum required of return is not earned by the firm, then we can say that firm fails to fulfill the promises made to the investors. Now, third point of view, that is capital expenditures point of view. It is also called the capital budgeting decisions. The cost of capital is the minimum required rate of return. It is also called the hurdle rate of return. It is also called the target rate. It is also called the cutoff rate or any discounting rate that is used to value the cash inflows. So here the cost of capital is also known as a hurdle rate, discount rate, target rate or cutoff rate. So different names are given to the cost of capital. Now some basic aspect of cost of capital. To understand the cost of capital in deep, we have to understand some of the basic terminology or basic concept. Number one is rate of return. Now your rate of return means what, right? The cost of capital is not cost as such. In fact, it is the rate of return that a firm requires to earn from its investment or from the project. So it is not a cost, right? But it is the required rate of return that is expected by the firm to earn from its investment. If firm is not able to earn that much required rate of return, then you can say that firm is financially fails, or firm's profitability is decreasing and firm will become insolvent. So here the profitability of the project depends on the, you know, the cost of capital and required rate of return. It is also called the minimum rate of return. Minimum rate of return expected by the fund supplier. And if firm maintain this minimum rate of return, then firm can sustain in the market, or firm can maintain its stock price in the market, or market value of the stock is maintained if firm can earn the minimum rate of return from the project or on the investment. Now there are three important components of the cost of capital. Number one, riskless cost of capital means there are sources of fund that there is no risk. Right. For example, if you invest in a bank, there is no risk. But apart from this bank, if you invest in capital market, then there is a risk. So our investment in capital market becomes the risky. But if you invest in a treasury bills, then there is no risk. So risk-free cost of capital or risk-free investment. Second thing is business risk. There are many types of risk in the business. Because of the natural calamities, fire, flooding situations, or strike from the employees, these different factors causes the trouble, problem to the firms, right? Then firm may have loss. The moment firm has loss, firm is not able to for its operating cost, its financial cost, it's a fixed cost. So it shows that firm's inability, not ability to earn the return which cover the fixed cost. So firm's inability to cover its fixed cost is called the business risk. Then the financial risk. Now, financial risk is also called technical risk. It is there in business. The moment we raise the fund through debt. Because on debt, we have to pay interest, irrespective of profit or loss. If we have a profit, then there is no problem in paying the interest. But the moment we have a loss, despite the loss, we have to pay interest on the debentures. So we can say that a firm's inability to cover the financial cost is also called the financial risk. So in order to understand the cost of capital properly, we have to understand the three things: riskless cost of capital, business risk that is related to the operation of the business, particularly not covering the fixed cost, and the financial risk, which is related to the financial cost, or you can say burden of interest. Importance of cost of capital. Cost of capital is the base for financing financial decision, right? Here, you know, there are three things which says that the cost of capital is very important. There are three types of decisions being taken by finance managers, and it's you know, these three types of decision based on the cost of capital. Number one, designing the optimum capital structure of capital structure. A capital structure shows the mix of debt and equity, right? But we have to optimize our capital structure. So what is called optimum capital structure? In the optimum capital structure, there is minimum cost of capital and maximum earning per share. So unless we lower down our cost of capital, unless we reduce the cost of capital, we cannot accelerate the earning per share, right? So the moment we increase our earning per share by lowering the cost of capital, then we can say we are able to design the optimum capital structure. Now, second thing, capital budgeting decision. Now, capital budgeting decisions are related with the fixed costs, or you can say, fixed assets. The moment we decide to purchase fixed assets or replace our old assets, you know, huge investment is required in capital budgeting decisions or in purchasing the fixed assets. So therefore, we have to evaluate two things of the fixed assets. Number one is cash outflow and cash inflows. Here in capital budgeting decisions, cash inflows is discounted by a cutoff rate. One cutoff rate is there. We have to discount that cash inflows, and then we can decide about the purchase of assets or, you know, technology. So the method of capital budgeting, for example, net present value method, internal rate of return methods, and profitability index methods, these three important methods are based on the cost of capital. So here we are using discount rate. That is, discount rate is nothing but the cost of capital. So entire capital budgeting decision, particularly NPV, IRR, and profitability index methods, based on the cost of capital. Then financial performance. How do we measure the performance, financial performance of the firms? So we consider the earning per share, we consider the net profit, we consider the economic value added, we consider the market value added, right? So all these you know, profitability indicators are compared with the cost of capital. And if these indicators, for example, return on investment is higher than the cost of capital, then we can say that we are able to increase our earning per share, we are able to increase economic value added, we are also able to increase the market value of the market value of the share in the capital market. So financial performance of any firms depends on the cost of capital. If there is a higher amount of cost of capital, then we can say that financial performance is not good, because there is a risk, right? And if there is no profit or there is loss, then firm cannot meet its cost of capital. So a firm may become insolvent, right? So therefore, you can say the financial performance of any firms depends on the cost of capital. Thank you.